أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا وطبيب نفوسنا أبي القاسم محمد. صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، لا سيما بقية الله روحه وأرواح العالمين لمقدمه الفداء. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد. اللهم صل وسلم على فاطمة الزهراء البتول الصديقة الراضية المرضية الشهيدة المضطهدة المغصوبة حقها، صلى الله عليها وعلى أبيها وبعلها وبنيها والسر المستودع فيها، صلوات محمد وعلى محمد. Respected scholars, all brothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum jami'an و رحمت الله و برکاته. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا و ما كنا لنهتدي لولا ان هدانا الله. الحمد لله على نعمة الايمان و كفى بها نعمة. الحمد لله that by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without us having paid anything for it, by the grace of the Almighty God, this is a favor upon you and I and all of us, inshallah, the lovers of Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salam. We had the opportunity of attending the majlis of the mother of all the Imams of Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salam. Especially when a majlis is held in commemoration of Bibi Fatima salamullah alayha, expect the Holy Prophet as her father, expect Amirul Mu'mineen as her husband, and expect all her children to host and attend, and all the angels, inshallah, attend. Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana lihaza. What are we doing here? Why is it that we are commemorating the majalis for Fatima al-Zahra salamullah alayha? Inshallah, first and foremost, in the first night, we want to make the right intention for our participation in her miraculous eloquent sermon known as Khutbe Fadakiyye Fatimatu Zahra Salamullah Alayha. She is putting forward a complaint, a serious complaint, not only against some so-called men of her time. Throughout the history, her speech is there as it has reached us as well. Part of her speech, she is complaining and she's addressing so-called Muslim. And she says, مَا هَذِهِ الْغَمِيزَةُ فِي حَقِّي وَالسِّنَةُ عَنْ ظُلَامَتِي. What's wrong with you so-called Muslims? Addressing those who lost, abandoned her and her husband after the demise of the Holy Prophet. What is this close eye that you have given to us about my right? وَالسِّنَةُ عَنْ ظُلَامَتِي. Are you up? Are you taking a nap? Are you asleep? Why are you so oblivious about what is happening to me? Don't you know who is this? This is the only daughter of the prophet left. This is the one that the prophet told you that she's part of my heart. Now, because Bibi Fatima Salamullah Alaiha, she has complained about those who are oblivious of her rights, about those who are so much indulged in dunya that they are not even aware of the Ayyam Fatimiyya. We are by the grace of God here to say, Bibi Fatima, Ya Fatima to Zahra, dear daughter of the Prophet, alas, I was not there in the year 11 after the migration of your father to sacrifice my life. Inshallah, hopefully if we were there, we would support you and your cause. But centuries later, here in Darussalam, 2018, 17 February, I heard there is a majlis for you in commemoration of you. I attend to say, Ya Fatima, I am not oblivious of your rights. Ya Fatima, I'm here to support your cause. And on the top of that, the topic for tonight and the theme, inshallah, for these nights is that, Ya Fatima, I'm here to seek the light of Fatima. I'm here to pay allegiance with you in your majlis, to make a covenant that, Ya Fatima, me and my family and my offspring, we wish to be on your party, on your line, in dunya and in akhirah. Bibi Fatima, inshallah, I will be quoting every night part of what she is expecting us to do. Ya Fatima to Zahra, I am here to give my greetings, and I have no doubt that the reply of greeting is an obligation. And therefore, I have no doubt, Bibi Fatima, when I'm laid down in my grave, and my grave is covered, family and friends leave me alone, and it will be me and myself and my actions, I have nothing to be proud of, other than humbly I say, I talk for myself, you can talk for yourself. Humbly I said, Ya Fatima to Zahra, by the grace of God, I was invited to sit here, read Majalis of Fatima. We attended, we sat in the Majlis of Fatima. Surely, inshallah, the tears that we share and we shed would please the heart of your father, your husband, your children, and yourself. Fatima, I'm here to say, As-salamu alayki ya bint Rasulullah. I expect your salam in dunya, and especially when I'm buried in my grave. Don't abandon me. Don't leave me alone in that very moment with salawat ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Definitely the most famous title, appellation, medal of honor, whatever you want to call it, of Bibi Fatima Salamullahi Alaiha, apart from her actual name, first name that she was given at birth, as you all know, is Az-Zahra. That's what the first title follows Fatima, is Fatima Az-Zahra. Tonight I want to tell you, inshallah, why the daughter of the Prophet was given this title of Az-Zahra. What kind of medal it is to appreciate, inshallah, your presence and your participation and your connection with Fatima as a link to your, inshallah, destination in eternal abode in paradise. But before I explain the meaning of Az-Zahra, I need to make a quick detour to prepare you, inshallah, for that meaning. And that is the following. Brothers and sisters, lo and behold, youngsters, elderly people, all of us, let us all remember that we are all travelers, okay? We are all travelers. Once upon a time in Australia, I was in a gathering and the Minister of Immigration and Citizenship was there as well. And I was talking to him. I said to him that, by the way, remember that even you are not the citizen of Australia. He was dumbfounded. He said, what are you talking about? Of course I am. I said, no. If you were, you would not be in this office today. The one before you was not either. This is just a temporary position given to you. One day you are appointed, the next day you are not. We are all on a temporary visa, whether we like it or not. Am I making sense or not? Even Anbiya, Awliya, Prophets, they were all on a temporary visa on this planet Earth. So brothers, it's because we are all travelers. This is just a temporary accommodation. No matter what kind of mansion or shabby house you and I have, at the end of the day is a temporary accommodation. We are going to leave it behind willy-nilly, whether we like it or not. Because we are travelers from the time of, you don't even need to be Muslim to accept this. Heraclitus, the ancient Greek philosopher and mathematician, he said it very correctly that you cannot step into the same river twice. Because you step into a river, you come out next few seconds, as quick as you want to jump back again, supposedly, because the flowing river is not the same river. If anyone does not see that, at least there is no question that 17th of February 2018 for you and I in Darussalam already expired. At least the sun of the 17th expired. And when it comes to time, there is no reverse gear. No matter what, elderly, you and I, we cannot reverse our life. We can only regret the past that we lost the opportunities. Youth, children, nobody can reverse. We are all travelers. Why do I say this? To prepare you for the rest of it. So there is no question that we are all travelers. When you are traveling, when you are moving, a basic philosophical fact is that when there is a motion, there is a destination. Simple. When there is a motion, there is a destination. Where is the destination? Inna lillah. You tell me the rest of it. Wa inna ilayhi. MashaAllah, raja'un. Ala ila Allah al-masir. Lo and behold, you are all going towards the Almighty God. Not only you are going towards God, the destination. You are all masir, brothers, sisters, is from Sara Yasiro. This ayah usually is not translated correctly or accurately. Masir is from Sara Yasiro. What does it mean in Arabic language? When in the process of fermentation, a wine is becoming vinegar, Arabs, they say Sara al-khamru khalla Sara. It means the wine became vinegar and now it's halal to drink it. Quran says, Ala ila Allah al-masir. Constantly you and I are becoming, better or bad. A better person, constantly, day and night, you and I are either getting closer to God or farther away from God. Constantly either getting closer to Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam or farther away, depending on whether we sin or we do righteous good deeds. When I was a kid, and forgive me to mention this game, I'm only mentioning it to pass the message, especially to the youngsters, clear message. When I was a kid, there was a game, I think it's an Indian game. It's called Snake and Ladder. Some of you, I see heads are nodding. So the game was like this, that you were like, depending on whether your dice is on the ladder or on the snake, you either lose or win, okay? It's just about whether, if you get to the ladder, all of a sudden you ascend. If you get to the snake, bang, puts you down. The story of life, I think there's a religious concept behind this game. I think the story of our life is like this. The moment a young boy is having a lustful look, that's a snake, down. Attending Majlis Fatimah al-Zahra, doing something good, that is ladder, go up. Make sure you get rid of snakes in your life and add more ladders to your life. All right? Now, in dunya, as travelers, because we are traveling, you cannot travel somewhere without either MasterCard, credit card, or cash, or somehow provision. In the old days, they used to carry their food provision with them. In today's world, they carry kind of currency or credit cards. You need provision. Quran, and I share with you ample ayat about this. To remember, please, the topic of tonight is something that we cannot afford forgetting for the rest of our life. Quran clearly says, constantly you are either gaining nur as your provision or nar. Nar is the fire. The more nar and fire you gain for yourself, the more compatible, God forbid, you become with the hellfire. And the more nur you gain for yourself and your soul, the more your soul becomes luminous and nurani. And as such, because God is nur, Allahu, you tell me the rest. Nuru samawat wal ard, mashallah. Dua command that you read, Ya Nuru, Ya Quddus. So the Almighty God is Nur. Allah is Nur of Samawati wal Ard. Of course, we are not talking about this physical Nur. In the Dua Joshan, therefore, Ya Khaliq al-Nur, Ya Munawwir al-Nur, Ya Nur al-Ghabla kulla Nur. Nur, when we refer to God, has a different meaning. If ever I get the opportunity, I will inshallah explain it. But for now, simple meaning that everyone can understand is guide. God is the guide, essentially. And when Ahlul Bayt or Nur are also because through the Nur of God, they become guides as well. So because God is Nur and He is the destination, as we already learned, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, if I want to have proximity with God, I need to also become luminous. Sallu ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. So the closer you get to God and godly people, the more luminous you become. This is how it is. So what is my business in dunya? What am I doing here in the Majlis of Fatimah al-Zahra? My friend, I'm here because I'm so greedy about gaining Nur. I'm after Nur. Wherever I find Nur, I go for it. Because I have no business in this dunya other than collecting Nur left and right, here and there, wherever that is possible. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I am the one who essentially deliver you and exit you from darkness to Nur. Allahu waliyu alladhina amanu. You tell me the rest of it. يخرجهم من الظلمات ما شاء الله إلى النور. God is essentially the guardian of the believers because they submitted and surrendered themselves to Him. God, you be my guide. He delivers them to Nur, from darkness. In Arabic, we use the term ظلمات in a plural sense. English doesn't have that capacity. Therefore, to translate it, you have to say layers of darkness. Types of darkness, darkness of ignorance, darkness of arrogance, darkness of polytheism and shirk, etc. From all these type of darkness, believers are expected to be delivered and exit to the Nur of guidance, to the Nur of love of Ahlul Bayt, to the Nur of proximity with the Almighty God. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you ever ask me, why did I send 124,000 prophets and messengers, summarize it in one word, I tell you, so that you gain Nur. That's it. Because I am Nur, and I want you to come to me, unless you have Nur, you cannot come to me. In Surah Ibrahim, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مُوسَىٰ إِلَىٰ وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مُوسَىٰ بِآيَاتِنَا مُوسَىٰ بِآيَاتِنَا أَنْ أَخْرِجْ قَوْمَكَ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. Surely we sent Moses with miracles that we provided him for the purpose of exit and deliver. Bring your community from darkness, type of darkness, to Nur. Do you see? And what the mission of Prophet Musa was, the rest of the prophets had the same mission. With the difference that when it comes to the Prophet of Islam, because the previous prophets, their mission was limited to their own community, time and space limit. Whereas the mission of the Prophet of Islam was universal, time and space. And therefore, in the beginning of Surah Ibrahim, the Almighty God says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alif Lam Ra. كتاب أنزلناه إليك لتخرج الناس من الظلمات إلى النور. Now here Quran, when he's talking to the prophets, so we have given you the Quran so that you deliver mankind, not your community, not only Khoja, not only Iranians or Arabs. لتخرج الناس استوسع رحمة الله. Don't limit the mercy of God. Don't limit the majalis of Fatima only to a particular group of people. Open the doors to all Muslims and non-Muslims, whoever wishes to attend. لتخرج الناس, so that you deliver mankind from darkness to Nur. So we are after Nur and delivering ourselves into the Nur. In dunya, various activities worship, all under the banner of worshiping acts. Remember, the Almighty God, the Rawayat, they tell you that. Do you know why we pray? Let me share a hadith that inshallah from tomorrow, our kids even enjoy the namaz and the ruku of the namaz. Boys, are you with me? Listen to this. Some children, unfortunately, or elderly people, I don't know why they are in such a rush. When they pray, we call it terrible prayer. Terrible prayer, very, very fast. The Prophet has an expression for it, just like someone, like a crow that, pick up the seeds. Relax, why are you in a rush? I tell you what, you're going to miss out if you are rushing it. Imam Ja'far Sadiq alayhi salam says, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. لا يركع عبد لله ركوعا على الحقيقة إلا زينه الله بنور بهائه. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. We get intoxicated by these infallible words. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says, no servant of God, no slave of God, no believer truly, sincerely bows for ruku for the sake of God unless while you're in the state of ruku, subhana rabbi al-azim wa bihamdi, you're downloading nur. You're downloading light from min nur baha'i. Allahu Akbar. From the majesty of God, from the grandeur of God, whatever you want to call it. So the longer you are in the state of ruku, the more download, the more nur you are getting. Don't forget that you are in this dunya for nur. And the more nur, the more you become luminous. And the more of the darkness in my soul will be disappeared until mashallah you glow. Rahmatullah alai a'la Allahumma qamar. Really, our scholars, I remember the early years of the early days. I had gone to study in Qom. First encounter with the marja in my whole life was Ayatollah Uzma Gulpaygani, rahmatullah alayhi. Allahu Akbar. If you see him like a moving globe, noor, full of light. This is a physical, and so I'm not just talking about the physical noor. The actual noor is the noor of the soul, but it reflects. Subhanallah, often you see nur in the face of people who are in the good habit of namaz shab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not only illuminates their hearts, even you see the nur on the face of such people. By the way, so the purpose of namaz, ruku is an example of it, is to download nur. Why is it that we go to Hajj? Those who have not been to Hajj and they can afford it, lo and behold, you are missing a lot of nur. And Hajj in its spirituality is so rich that once in your lifetime, it's just like taking very strong medicine, the needle that you take, that the doctors, they tell you that this is enough for the rest of your life. How rich Hajj is with the spirituality. Again, Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says, لِكُلِّ شَعْرَةٍ نُورٌ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ وَحَلْقُ الرَّأْسِ لِكُلِّ شَعْرَةٍ نُورٌ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ. You go to Hajj, you shave or shorten, for every hair there is a nur for you, there is a light for you. Isn't that what you are after? Why is it that we are fasting? Amirul Mu'mineen, every year he looks at the new crescent of the month of Ramadan, said, Ya Allah, grant me the nur of this month. I want to enter the holy month of Ramadan to gain the nur of the month of Ramadan. In the darkness of the night, subhanallah, brothers and sisters, this nur, you can find it in the jet black night. In the darkness of night, all eyes closed, people asleep, lights off, nobody knows. But the one who needs to know is watching you. You wake up by the grace of God. تَتَجَافَ جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ. They leave bed, quietly go make their wudu and stand to pray on their prayer mat. Keep this in mind when I'm talking about the meaning of Zahra. I'll come back to this. سَبَبُ النُّورْ فِي الْقِيَامَةِ الصَّلَاةِ فِي جُوفِ اللَّيْلِ. الله أكبر. Imam Sadiq says, you want nur? Go to the darkness of the night, quietly, secretly. Make intimacy, love with God. Let nobody know. But God knows. And because the more secret, the more nur you get. Less show off. Sabab al-nur, those who are after nur in qiyamah, namaz-e-shab. Don't miss out. Sallu ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. The practical, the teacher of Imam Khomeini, practical Irfan, Mirza Jawad al-Maliki Tabrizi, rahmatullah alayhi, a'la Allah maqamah, whose inner senses were active. One of his students narrates, he says, once we were coming back from the lesson from Dars, and Mirza Jawad told me that let's go just pay a quick visit to a student, one of the talibe, a young sheikh, in a boarding school, boarding house. Somebody, students, talibe, they were living. I accompanied him, we went there, and he just went to one of the rooms in the dormitory of the school. A young sheikh talibe, he came out, he greeted him, kissed him, and said, thank you very much, and he left. On the way back home, I said, Sheikh Ono, did you know him? He said, no. Yes and no. I said, so how come you went, just greeted him quickly, what did you thank him for? He said, last night I was on my prayer mat, and all of a sudden I saw a nur coming to me. I found kind of illumination inside myself. It wasn't from me, I hadn't done anything. I paid attention, and I saw it's coming from that room, of that school. I realized that this talibe is praying namaz shab, and in the qunut of namaz shab that you pray for 40 believers, he's praying for me. So when you pray for each other, you're sending nur for each other, Allahu Akbar. Be greedy, share the nur with each other. Send the nur ahead for your children also as well. وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا. Alright, so prayers, fasting, everything, all of this are for the purpose of gaining the nur. Whatever is possible, asad ghul nur, or any good deed that you do from today, remember, you convert, it will be converted to nur and comes back to you in the form of nur. Today in the madrasa for the girls, I share the hadith with them, let me share it with the kids here as well. Elderlies will benefit from it as well. When you are doing tasmihat Fatima with your fingers, and divide, God has already divided every finger to three bands. Okay? Do tasbihat Fatima with your fingers become blessed. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And every day, five times after every namaz, and six times before you go to bed, as you know as well, your fingers become blessed. And because your fingers become blessed, your fingers become luminous. Keep this with me now. Opportunities given to you and I, day and night, the longer inshallah, the better, until we expire. Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. All of a sudden, no more opportunity is given. And I start my journey, my life of barzakh. Now let's look. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran demonstrates the situations of the believers and the hypocrites. Disbelievers is obvious. Hypocrites. Quran says in Surah Al-Hadid, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يوم ترى المؤمنين والمؤمنات يسعى نورهم بأيديهم وبأيمانهم يسعى نورهم بين أيديهم وبأيمانهم بشراكم اليوم يوم ترى. Addressing the Prophet, my dear Prophet, you see the believing men and women. To make it clear that it's not gender issue. Believing men and believing women. You will see them, يَسْعَى نُورُهُمْ بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَبَأَيْمَانِهِمْ. Now the nur that you had gained and reserved for yourself in your heavenly saving account, now your nur is coming back to you. Inshallah, nur, I don't need to always say light, you know the meaning of nur. Your light is coming back to you, your spiritual light, your provision of akhira is coming back to you in all different forms and leads you to to paradise. Where is paradise? Paradise also is a place of nur. The Holy Prophet says, لَمَّا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ الْجَنَّةَ خَلَقَهَا مِن نُورِ وَجْهِ. Allahu Akbar. God created paradise from the nur of his face. Go there, experience it, and let me know what it is. Whatever we say now is just assumption. Somebody was saying that at the end of the day, time will come that God is saying five words. You all got me wrong. Until you go to paradise, otherwise nobody knows. We are just hearing the words. By the way, يَسْعَى نُورُهُمْ بَيْنَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَبِأَيْمَانِهِمْ. God says, glad tidings, good on you, mashallah. You've come with provision. Unfortunately, the next ayah shows, not unfortunately, fortunately, that we are exposed to this information to avoid it. Among our community, Ya Rab, inshallah, none of us are included. Among Muslim community are those who had given lip service in dunya. They never had time for their religion. They never had money for their religion. They had more important things to do. Quran refers to them as hypocrites, double-faced people. You look at them, look Muslims, name Muslim, practice, unfortunately nothing. Therefore, no nur has been gained. يَوْمَ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتُ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا انظُرُونَا. They are beggars. Have you ever been bankrupt, God forbid? Inshallah not. Have you been financially down? Inshallah not seriously. Bankruptcy of dunya is by far easier than the bankruptcy of the hereafter, for the reason that I tell you. Bankruptcy in dunya, I have seen, met them, often they get to the stage of being suicidal, yet after a few years they build again themselves. It's not the end of the world. But the bankruptcy of akhirah is very detrimental. Quran says, the day will also come that the hypocrite men and hypocrite women, they turn and on and talk to their relatives, friends, people of the Jama'ah, they knew, Haji, brother, Haji, I know him, Unadhuruna, please look at me, please, hello, pay attention to me. Naqta, what do you want? Naqta bisman nurakum, is there any penny? Any shilling of nur? Please, give me a little bit of your nur. I have nothing to move forward. I don't have any provision for my akhirah. Look at what Quran says. قِيلَ رَجِعُوا وَرَاءَكُمْ فَالْتَمِسُوا نُورًا. Too late, mate. There is no nur shade here. You have to go back. اِرْجِعُوا وَرَاءَكُمْ. Reverse. Did I tell you in the beginning there is a reverse gear or not? I said there is no reverse gear. Therefore, there is no reverse gear. This ارجعوا وراءكم يعني just regret. Just alas. Just I wish. It's nothing more than a wish. A wishful thought. I wish I could return to dunya. ارجعوا وراءكم. Go back, see how much nur was in the majlis of Fatima al-Zahra. You missed out, my friend. The majlis was open. The door of the masjid was open. You missed out. Didn't you receive the information? When the call for azan was heard, didn't you hear it? You did hear it. You put the blanket on you. You ignored it. ارجعوا وراءكم فالتمسوا. Seek nur from dunya. If you sought nur from dunya, then you will be illuminated and illuminous. Long story short, subhanAllah, what a long introduction, but it will benefit us, inshallah, for the first of the nights as well. So remember, brothers and sisters, to conclude in a nutshell, we are here in this dunya to be luminous. Constantly be luminous. Ahlul Bayt alayhimu salam, Bibi Fatima salamullah alayha, came to this dunya, and she, before that she had the nur. In dunya she shared that nur, because once you shine, once you become luminous, you shine, people around you will also become nurani. In so much as I'm sitting now, lights are reflecting on my face is bright. If I turn my face, it becomes dark. You turn towards Fatima, towards Ahlul Bayt, you become also illuminated. You turn away from them, you become dark. You become in. Why is it that the enemies of Ahlul Bayt are cursed? Because they turn away from them. ظُلُمَاتٌ بَعْضُهَا فَوْقَ بَعْضٍ إِذَا أَخْرَجَ يَدَهُ لَمْ يَكَدْ يَرَاهَا. They are completely blind and dark in the darkness, on the top of the darkness. Now, we go back to the discussion. Why is it that the most important title and the medal of honor of Bibi Fatima is Az-Zahra? Because there is no more important mission in this dunya rather than gaining nur. And Fatima is Az-Zahra. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says, because لَأَنَّهَا كَانَتْ تَزْهَرُ لَأَهْلِ السَّمَاوَاتِ إِذَا كَانَتْ تَقُومُ فِي مِحْرَابِهَا تَزْهَرُ لَأَهْلِ السَّمَاوَاتِ كَمَا يَزْهَرُ الْكَوَاكِبُ لِأَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ. صلوا على محمد وعلى محمد. زهره يزهرو in Arabic it means when something is shining. Anara is shining, is glittering. In Arabic the blossom is called zahr, because it's attracting attention. Venus, you don't have it in English, but in Arabic, the star Venus, the brightest star in the night sky, is called Zuhre, because it's shiny, it's very bright. Fatima is Az-Zahra, because of the brightness of her soul, because of the brightness of her face. When she's standing on her prayer mat praying, she is like illuminating people of heaven. People of heaven, you take a candle out under the sun, nobody notices the light of it. To be able to illuminate and glow for people of heaven, imagine the light that she must have. And that's why Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq alayhi salam says that Summiyat, also it's a second hadith. These are levels of knowledge. Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salam were answering individuals depending to the level of their capacity of their knowledge and understanding. Another one comes and asks Imam Sadiq. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says that my grandfather says that innama summiyat az-zahra la'anna Allah khalaqaha min nur azamati. Allahu akbar. La'anna Allah khalaqaha min nur azamati. The Almighty God is ma'dinul azama. He is the source of grandeur and greatness. Now from that source of grandeur and greatness, God created Fatima. That's why understand knowing Fatima is beyond our knowledge. As understanding the greatness of God is beyond our knowledge. Just so that you have a kind of vague idea. The entire creation of God is great. It's not only that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Allahu Akbar, but somebody was saying that why there is no miracle. I said, are you awake or asleep? Delivering a baby, isn't it a miracle? Look at the tree, look at the flowers. My teacher, Ayatollah Hasanzadeh Hafizahullah, he was saying that if you were just coming from another planet, or just born mature, and somebody brings a rose flower to you and tells you that, look, this rose flower, look at the pebbles, look at this, the fragrance, and how soft, nice. It's coming from this rough trunk of branch of a tree with all the thorns. Would you believe it? Isn't this a miracle? So everywhere you look, I have this metaphorical expression, everywhere you look, including yourself, the most atheist person speaking against the existence of God does not realize that his tongue, the fingerprint of God is on his tongue. Unless there was a creator, you would not be able to speak. You are a living miracle of God yourself in your creation, and yet you are denying the existence of God. But of the miracles, of the ayat of God, some are greater, some less. Amirul Mu'minin is Ayatullah al-Kubra. Okay, therefore the nur that Amirul Mu'minin has is greater. Do you want me to tell you the last meaning of Fatima that we have mentioned in the Rawayat? Then our mind is going to blow. Sallu ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. In another hadith, to a deeper level, Imam Ja'far Sadiq alayhi salam says, "Innama summiyat Zahra la'annaha kanat tazharu li'amir al-mu'minin." I cannot fathom. Amir al-mu'minin gets illuminated, he's getting his nur from Fatima as a link between him and the Holy Prophet. The only existing link between him and the Holy Prophet. Amir al-Mu'minin is the one that when you go to Najaf al-Ashraf and do ziyarat, Amir al-Mu'minin say, "Assalamu alaik ya nur al-anwar." All those who are illuminated, they get the nur from you. Yet, ya Amir al-Mu'minin, Imam Sadiq says, Fatima gives you nur. لأنها كانت تزهر لأمير المؤمنين. And yet, such a great lady, Salamullah alayha, she becomes one of the five most crying people. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says, Al-Bakaun khamsa. Five people in their lifetime. And subhanallah, the life of Fatima, especially the last 3 months of her life, right from the demise of her father until her martyrdom. Adam, Ya'qub, Prophet Yusuf alayhimus salam, Fatima, and the fifth one, Imam Sajjad, after the tragedy of Karbala. I mentioned yesterday on Friday, I want to repeat here, the reason that the tragedy of Bibi Fatima hurts us deep, because she never raised sword against anyone. Because she was a female, she was a lady. She was the daughter of the Prophet. She was a young, pregnant lady, my friend. She didn't go out even fighting, arguing anyone. She's in her home. They attacked her in the security of her house. A pregnant lady. You don't need to be a Muslim to respect and give room to a pregnant lady. It's a very basic human thing. Let me tonight read the majlis from her own words. I have a humble question, Bibi Fatima. Why is it that you are crying so much after your father? That Imam Ali had to make for you Baytul Ahzan, the house of grief. She explains herself in a poetry way. صبت علي مصائب لو أنها صبت على الأيام صرنا لياليا. If you ask me, why is it that I'm weeping and crying day and night? Because calamities befell on me after my father. So many calamities that if they had fallen on the bright days would turn them to dark nights. What are those calamities, O dear daughter of the Prophet? Narrate to us. فَجَمَعُ الْخَطَبَ بِبَابِنَا. I'm quoting her words. She is the victim of the tragedy and the victim is the narrator tonight. فَجَمَعُ الْخَطَبَ بِبَابِنَا لَيُحْرِقُوا وَيُحْرِقُونَنَا. They brought the fire and the firewood to my doorstep to burn the door of my house and to burn the house. They threatened that we are going to burn the house if the household don't come out. Somebody says, وَفِيهَا فَاطَمَا. In this house is the part of the heart of the Prophet Fatima. And he says, وَأَنْ سُوَّتْ. I don't care. Fatima al-Zahra, for those who say, why Amir al-Mu'mineen didn't go to get the door or to fight them? Because they were not there to fight. Fatima says, I told Ali ibn Abi Talib, my cousin, Miqdad, Salman, and those who were in my house, seeking refuge in my house, I told them, I'm a lady. I'm a pregnant lady. I am the daughter of the Prophet. Perhaps they shy away. Let me go talk to them. And I went and I put my hands against the sides of the door. وَنَاشَدْتُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ وَبِأَبِي رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. I took the oath in the name of Allah and my father, the messenger of Allah. أَن تَكُفُّوا عَنَّا وَتَنُصُرُونَا. I said, if you don't help us, at least leave us alone. We are not fighting you, you go back. As I was talking to them, explaining, all of the sudden, I saw the door falling on my face. فَسَقَطَتْ عَلَىٰ وَجْهَا عَلَىٰ الْهَامِ. I fell on the floor. I felt the pang of delivery. فَقَدْ أَسْقَطُوا جَنِينِهِ بِغَيْرِ جُرْمٍ. And therefore I cried painfully, يَا فِضَّا خُذِينِي. ألا لعنة الله على القوم الظالمين وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون. Please be conscious of your habaij, especially quickly appearance of Imam Zaman, Shifa Marizan Islam, Qada Hawaj Mu'minin and Mu'minat, inshallah good ending for all of us and our springs all the way to the day of judgment. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Amman yujibu al-muzdarra idha da'ahu wa yakshifu su'. أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءَ. 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 بِجَاهِ مُحَمَّدٍ وَآلِ مُحَمَّدٍ وَبِحُرْمَةِ الْفَاتِحَةِ مَعَ الصَّلَوَاتِ.